What up, YouTube? Today I'm going to be showing you a really easy, pretty much foolproof way to cook an entire turkey. Let's get started. This is going to be an overnight slow cooked turkey. You're going to brine your turkey for at least 24 hours, season your turkey inside and out, do a quick high temperature roast on the turkey, then you're going to slow cook the turkey overnight to seal in all the flavor and the juices. I'm already bringing some water up to a boil to start my brine, and now I'm going to clean this turkey and get it prepped to go in the brine bin. This is a 2 gallon brine. Use 1 cup salt, 2/3 cup sugar, and 1 cup seasoning, equal parts garlic powder, rubbed sage, and margarine. Somebody hit me up in the comments that I'm saying that improperly. If you've never made a brine before, it's very simple. I make a lot of brines. If you've watched some of my other cooking videos, I smoke a lot of food. When you're smoking food that's not pork or has a low fat content, specifically chicken, you're always gonna want a brine. Otherwise, it's typically gonna dry it out. What I've done here is I've got this brine bin that I've created. I measured this thing out and I marked the 1 gallon spot and the 2 gallon spot. I add enough ice in here to get it to the 2 gallon and I've got a 2 gallon brine. Same thing with a 1 gallon. Once you've marked this, it's pretty easy to make up brines without having to do a bunch of measuring of the liquids. I'll put some ice in my brining bin. I add the brine itself. See, the editor slash director, which is all me, would have said, you poured that from the wrong direction. You should have poured it towards the camera. I'm just gonna fill up the rest of this up to the 2 gallon brine mark with cold water. You wanna make sure that your brine bin fits in a refrigerator somewhere in your house. Most all these brines that you do are gonna be long brines in the fridge, and the last thing you wanna do is make up a brine bin, put a turkey in it, and then realize that you have to remove shelves from your refrigerator in order to get it in there. Second thing you wanna check in your brine bin, if you're doing this for turkey, then it will fit in there. Because if your turkey doesn't fit in your brine bin and is not completely covered, again, you just made a brine bin that you can't really use for what you're using it for. In goes the turkey. Like a glove. Turkey's been in the brine for 24 hours, just about 24 hours. Today's the cook day. Plan on a 24 hour cook. That's gonna vary based on the size of your bird, but that's a really good starting point. I'm gonna get this bird out of the brine, rinsed off, and seasoned. Stuff this bird loosely with some seasoned green apples. This adds flavor, moisture to the cook, these apples get seasoned with sage and thyme. Get back in there. Next, we're gonna make up our butter seasoning for underneath the skin. This is 1 stick of butter, 1 tablespoon of thyme, 1 tablespoon of rosemary, and 1 tablespoon of sage. Jam this in underneath the skin. The main place that you're trying to get this butter is right here. The white meat on these turkeys is the spot that wants to dry out. The brine helps, but to really add flavor to these turkey breasts, you put this butter mixture right on top and all around each breast. Now I'm gonna clip this guy back into position, close up the cavity, hit this with olive oil, SPG, salt, pepper, garlic, rosemary, thyme, and go heavy-handed on the seasoning. This is a big bird, margarine. Same thing on this side. The two issues people usually have when cooking a turkey, one, drying it out, and two, it's not flavorful enough. The second one can be taken care of with a good gravy. That's how people patch fix that one. The first one, unfortunately, you could try and repair it with gravy, but everybody knows if you dry out a turkey, you've dried out a turkey. That's that. We're gonna cook this at 425 convection bake for 1 hour. Pull this bird. Now I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, man, that looks good already. And it does. And it smells fantastic. And we haven't even really cooked the bird. All that did was brown the outside, kill off any bacteria, get it looking nice and pretty. Because after this, we go to the cover cook. I'm gonna let this bird sit out for just a minute, or a couple of minutes actually. All I'm trying to do is I'm trying to get the outside skin of this to drop down in temperature just a little bit, so that as I spritz it with the chicken stock, it doesn't all just evaporate. And this is just chicken stock. Instead of dumping the chicken stock on the bird, which washes off a lot of these seasonings, I am just going to spray. It's a little bit messier, a little bit more time consuming, but as you see, it's not washing all my seasonings off. The rest of this chicken stock, I'm gonna pour into the cavity and just let it run out of the bird. The last seasoning that goes on this is plain old poultry seasoning. I put the poultry seasoning on now. This stuff is such a light dust that if you put it on any earlier, it washes off. You take all your side fittings, your neck, just lay that in there, your heart, liver, giblets, and I just put it in the pan and lightly season those guys with salt, pepper, garlic. You want to cover it tightly. I also use my barbecue temperature probe. Gives you a gauge of the temperature of the cook. Now I'm gonna set the oven for non-convection bake at 190 degrees and just let it go. Day two of the cook. My turkey has been in there for 24 hours, actually a little bit over 24 hours. I'm gonna give you guys a pro tip. Most ovens have a cutoff where they'll only run for a certain amount of time. Mine is 12 hours, which is actually really good, but you wanna make sure you know how long your oven will run before it automatically cuts off. The second thing is, you wanna cook this bird to 165, 175, somewhere in that range. The advantage of doing this long overnight cook is everything in there is rising to temperature evenly because it's happening so slowly. So when you get the bird to 165, the whole bird is at 165. That's why I like this cooking technique. It's easy, it's pretty much foolproof. I have an oven temperature gauge in there. Household ovens are not great at holding very low temperature evenly. I have to keep mine set to 190, but the actual internal temperature of the oven is 170. So check that, because what you're going for is 170. Regardless of how you get there, that's what you want to hold it at.
Do you know what that is? That's a turkey.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my gosh, that smells so good, doesn't it? Does it smell yummy? Sniff it.
Oh. Yummy, yummy. Mm-hmm.